no matter where you work hard or play hard, the CASIO G'zOne Commando from Verizon Wireless is built for you. Hey, how you doing? This is George Price here in Pelton, Indiana. And what I'm talking about today is the CASIO G'zOne Commando from Verizon Wireless. CASIO's always been known for innovation, but on this one, they really shine. Now, I'm not going to go over all the specifications. I'll put a link down below for those, because if you're like me, you're going to get a lot more of those if you read those yourself. But it's a sweet, sweet smartphone, and offers anyone who decides to make their own a lot. One of the first things I noticed about the CASIO G'zOne Commando is the way it's constructed. It's held together through screws up front, screws on the rear, and also has this nice rubber case for a sure grip no matter what you're doing. The speakers up front have a great sound, and CASIO said they've enhanced them for the way people use them outside. Now, one thing some folks might consider a downside to the CASIO G'zOne Commando from Verizon Wireless is the battery. It's a standard lithium ion battery, usage up to average usage up to 9 hours, standby 16. But for a lot of people who are tracking, biking, hiking, outdoors, working in, say, construction sites, for a lot of folks, this is going to be their second phone. Now, while it is sort of great for your just your all-time phone, still, a lot of people use this for the for their smartphone when they're out doing outside activity or at work. And what I've seen, and appears they're working very well, are some solo chargers. And I'm pretty sure when folks are out long-term camping or camp for the weekend or long-term trekking or hiking or biking, that's probably one of the sources they choose the solar chargers to keep their smartphones and other tech equipment fully charged. One of the very cool features about the CASIO G'zOne from Verizon Wireless is the way you unlock it. Either hit the unlock key twice, or you can hit the camera button twice and be ready to take that picture. Another thing, once it's unlocked, that you'll notice is that when you tap this to turn the compass off and on. So if you need your compass right away when you're out tracking, all you gotta do is hit the tab and go from your phone back to your compass. The pictures I've taken with the CASIO G'zOne Commando from Verizon Wireless, I've been very happy with those. Great pictures. I did a couple videos the other day. The first one at a construction site here locally, and that video turned out pretty well. I did another one a few hours later downtown here inside the post office, and I wasn't very pleased with the video I put online, and I'll put some links for those down below. But what all the videos out of the CASIO G'zOne are 3G, and I usually take the videos on my phone, put it in my editing system to cut off anything on the front or the back that I may not need in the video. And I had to convert these 3G videos to something I could edit with my video editing system. This past Sunday, I decided to try something else. I went back downtown and did another video. And instead of converting that and in my editing system, I upload that direct to YouTube from the CASIO G'zOne. And that video turned out pretty good. And what I'm thinking, perhaps CASIO had in mind for these videos, folks that use these phones when they're out working or tracking or something like that, are going to want a smaller 3G video so they can put that up online right away, or perhaps send it by text to our family or buddies to claim, show everybody what they've accomplished. So I'm thinking, and I've seen some other videos from the CASIO G'zOne online that folks say they weren't too happy with, but it's perhaps the way we're getting this online. I think that if we do a video with the CASIO G'zOne, it's intended to upload that mobile version of the video direct to YouTube or whatever service that you want to use, or text it to whomever you're going to show it to. The CASIO G'zOne Commando from Verizon Wireless is one very tough phone. And part of the way it's constructed, many of the ports have these caps on them. Again, it's rubberized case it has for things that do happen, and phones do get dropped. And it can be immersed in water up to 1 meter, which is a little over 3 feet, for 30 minutes. It can be dropped 4 foot 26 times, and CASIO says it will withstand that, and it's vibration resistant. And I'll put a link down to that information also. You can get all this information from Verizon Wireless about this. But again, it's a tough smartphone, and these caps on the ports help protect it from moisture and from dust. Another thing you're going to notice about the CASIO G'zOne Commando is this point here on the bottom. And what that's for, it's for an accessory wrist strap to keep the phone secure while you're out trekking across the country, canoeing, bicycle riding. There's a lot of shaking going on out there. What I mean is some of the apps that you download have you shake the phone to get it to perform some function. And if you stop to think about it, most smartphones and other devices weren't designed to be shaken around or perhaps anything like that. And the CASIO G'zOne Commando is vibration resistant, so maybe apps like that would be a little less harmful to it. And things, you know, do go bump in the night, and cell phones do get dropped, and CASIO says the G'zOne Commando can withstand up to 26 4 foot drops. A couple things I wish my personal phone had, and I could use these often, is one, a built-in flashlight. And you don't know how many times that would have come in handy. And it also has glove mode. And again, if you're out doing some serious bicycling or hiking or something like that, and I'm trying to use other smartphones with a glove, you find out that you either need to download an app for that, or you just have to take off your glove and use the phone. And some things that really set the CASIO G'zOne Commando for Verizon Wireless apart are the G's World and G's Gear. The first one we're going to talk about is G's World. And this is all about your outdoor activities, your walking, your trekking, your bicycle riding, and you can keep track of your progress, let others know what your progress is. Whether it be walking or canoeing or bicycling or any other kind of activity, you can keep all records on all that. And again, you can blast it out on social media to let someone know what you've done, or take a video, a 3G video, and send it to them to show them where you're at. And the thing about the 3G videos being smaller than videos from some other smartphones, it doesn't take near as much data to send that video to someone. And then we have G's Gear, which is just totally cool. And G's Gear includes an earth compass, a thermometer, information on tides, when the sun rises or is going to set, what time. And that's important if you're on a long trek or bicycle ride. If you like to stargaze, it's got location of the stars in the sky, a walking counter, a barometer, and then you can add your own settings in there, a pedometer. But about the earth compass, this is just totally cool. Part of, there's seven layers, and they include national parks, world mountains, world nature, world cities, and you can add your own layer if you're going to stay close to the home as to how far things are as the bird flies. This is a direct line, and there's your compass that tell you where, what direction, and how far it is to any of those. That's just, it's just totally something that sets the CASIO G'zOne Commando from Verizon Wireless apart from other smartphones. The CASIO G'zOne from Verizon Wireless would make a great phone for anybody, for whether it's going to be your only phone that you use, or whether, like some people, have it for a second phone for that outdoor activity, your sports, or maybe some kind of work you do where you need a phone that's just a little tougher for the environment you're in. Another great use for this phone, this is one of Verizon Wireless's more economical phones. And with young people, when you feel like they're ready to get started with a smartphone, this would be an excellent choice because, again, it's shock resistant, water resistant, in case you know what can go wrong does and gets dropped. And some of the G's World and G's Gear in a phone may entice that young person to seek a healthier lifestyle with the sports activities, keeping track of what they're doing as far as their school sports, perhaps, or sports outside of school, and or learning more about where things are located in the world, the parks and the parks, U.S. parks, or parks all over the world, world mountains. It could really be something that could a young person could really get into. So I'll put links to all this information again down below, so the specifications and more about G's World and G's Gear for you to check out, and links to the videos I have done so you can take a look at that. But again, it's a serious smartphone, and one that's well worth considering. The reviews I use are from users like you. Sometimes you might see reviews out there that are a little bit biased, say from the manufacturer. If I'm getting ready to buy any kind of equipment, whether it be a camera, a microphone, a smartphone, the reviews I use for that are from users like you. If you got any comments or questions, pop down below and I'll do the very best I can to answer them for you. Oh, and be sure to subscribe. From Pendleton, Indiana, wherever you are, hoping you have a great day. This is George Price.